like the video and subscribe right now. An evil doggo will never attack you. Ask Reddit. Men of Reddit, what is a man's secret that you think every man should know? Boxer briefs are better than boxers or briefs. I can vouch for this. I disagree for that small percentage of men who have a large button thighs. The boxer briefs ride up my leg to look like briefs after 15 minutes, negating the purpose of the boxer in boxer briefs. From a female perspective, I agree wholeheartedly. Tagless boxer briefs are the way to go. I recently switched to boxer briefs and I feel like the regular cotton ones lose the leg elasticity very quickly after one or two wears. It bounces back every time you wash and dry them, but it's gone within 10 minutes of wear. Polyester/spandex boxer briefs are really expensive but amazing. I use them for running, and I don't even notice them. They don't shift around at all, even after 10 plus mile runs. The downside is they can't go in the dryer. Edit, I should also mention that my fiancé really likes the way they look on me. If you have a nice man booty or thighs, they really make you look good. They're like dude thongs, no underwear line. Learn some basic maintenance skills. If the women don't find you handsome, they should at least find you handy. Stay well groomed. It stuns me how many men don't get this. Just because we don't obsess over beauty products doesn't mean we shouldn't shower on a regular basis. Don't worry so much about what others think of as manly. You're a man. Doing laundry isn't going to make your penis shrink. Nor for men. Because a scrotum is a pain in the ass to shave. Keep the following with you whenever you leave the house: pocket knife, close to a dollar in change, some actual cash and a condom. I've been waiting for as long as I can remember to see the commercial. Scene: men's locker room. Hey, Bob, your dog's getting a little shaggy. Try this. What's that? It's Nair. Four balls. Nair? Four balls? Yup. Nair. Four balls. Voice over. Nair four balls. Apply directly to your balls. Upvote for the red-green reference. My uncle is a boilermaker welder and his advice is to never put your finger where you wouldn't put your dick. Very sound. It's the other way round, bro. Not sure if I'd be willing to put my dick on the doorknob, in the pantry, on the refrigerator, in the dirt of my garden, and in my friend's hand. A sane 6 is better than a crazy 9. Stay away from materialistic girls with no concept of money. You don't want to be paying for shit years after you had your last duck with her. Don't go to the grocery store hungry. Don't forget to shit before going for a run. And always jack off before making an important decision. Fap fap fap, I'll take white rice please. Well, this used car looks good and the price is attractive, but where's the bathroom? Always jack off before making an important decision. Crap thunder. So how'd you come up with that name then? Edit, guys, I get it. Insanity wolf slash rocky. I knew this beforehand. I just found it an amusing coincidence. The last two are applicable no matter what kind of guy you are. Confidence is the ducking key to everything. It is also the key to ducking everything. Define confidence. You know that cream that removes leg hair for women? Don't use that on your balls. Just don't. Edit. Someone gifted me some Reddit gold for this. Thanks very much. I have learned from these poor fellows. Read the reviews. I'm getting conflicting advice on this. I'm gonna trust the other guys. Used it twice. No problem. Third time. Medical attention. Put salt in ice water in a cooler to chill drinks super fast. Pick your battles. Relationships, at work, at school, with friends, etc. Being right isn't important all the time. Simple wet rub for steak, Worcestershire sauce, salt, pepper, onion powder. Mix it together, rub on the steak, either put in Ziploc bag for 30 minutes or grill immediately. Keep a sweater in your car. Your wife slash girlfriend slash date will be cold at some point in time. Look baller by having a spare. Put the seat down and shut up about it. Get a prostate exam yearly starting at 35. 30 if you've had a family history of it. Accept the gloved finger. Move along. Edit. There is some contention on this. I'm older and not a scientist or doctor. I'm sure there is plenty of research out there that proves me wrong on the correct methods of detection. Regardless, get tested for prostate cancer in whatever method is recommended via research or professional advice. I've watched several family members die to this, and it is preventable with early detection. Dressing well is easy. Ross, Savers, and Goodwill can net you fantastic clothing at super cheap prices. Plus, as ZZ Top reminds us, the ladies go crazy for a sharp dressed man. Talk, don't text with someone you want to connect with. Applicable everywhere, work, school, and socially. Being right isn't important all the time. I think you're wrong. You're doing God's work. Can I add, buy yourself a nice pair of shoes for when you take your girl out / go to the club edit, trim your mustache. Girlfriend reminded me of this when she woke up. Source, Fatman, who is constantly complimented by girls for his shoes. As an addition to your dressing well comment, suits and shirts don't have to be the whole of your paycheck, especially on a budget. Buy a suit from Masses on sale, or what have you, and get it tailored. A perfect fitting budget suit is 1,000 times better than an ill-fitted expensive suit. Put the seat down, and shut up about it. And pee all over it? I don't understand. Still, learn to flirt through text. The talking instead of texting is a perfect statement. A real conversation is infinitely better than a drone text. Picking your battles is such a good thing to learn when you're young. Noon likes the guy who's always argumentative. This especially applies to work. Politeness and empathy is the key to all human interactions. Don't use being honest as an excuse to act like an ass. Being polite and honest are not mutually exclusive. If you say things like "at least I'm not bullshitting you," or "I just say what I feel to excuse bad behavior," you are doing it wrong. Being nice to people and having manners isn't being fake. It's being an adult. Also, women are people too. This seems obvious, but I think a lot of young men don't seem to realize the way they are behaving reflects that this isn't something they are aware of. They aren't a mysterious race of creatures that are all conspiring. They are individuals, shaped by predisposition and life experiences just like you. Treat them like they are just like you, not like an obstacle to be overcome. Edit, for emphasis on a point that it seems was missed on most of the negative responses in my inbox. Totally agree with all of this advice. And about the honesty thing, when someone pulls a line, like "I'm just being honest," what do you say back? To call them out on their assholery? Any ideas? Girl here. Can't agree with this enough. And not only is it basic human decency, but not being polite and treating women like they're extraterrestrials are both deal breakers for almost all women. Keeping your fingernails neat and trimmed is a sign of sexual intelligence. No girl wants you venturing around her nether regions with jagged talons. Amen to that. Hate to be fingered with nasty sharp nails. Further, once you trim with clippers, get a nail file and smooth the jaggers out. Use actual sandpaper if you need the man points. Biting ain't no nervous habit. It's preparing. Never have I heard more truth. You don't have to get married, even though it seems like that is all everyone is talking about. It's not a bachelor pad. It's a bachelor kingdom. Conversely, marriage isn't the end of your life. If there is someone you truly love and care for, get to know them completely and intimately. Date for a significant amount of time. Then move in together. Share the bills, chores, have lots of sex, do things that married people do. And when you realize that you want to spend the rest of your life with her, it won't be a ball and chain, because you'll know that you're compatible, and that you want to be with her, and that you cannot imagine your life without her. If you ever have to ask the question, "Should I get married?" the answer is no. When it's time, you will know it deep down, through and through. Ditto having children. Putting Rogaine on your face every day for a month will not make your beard grow in better / thicker. It will just give you horrible acne. Source, I'm a ducking dumbus. I won't lie, I have thought about it. Thank you for saving me from trying it. Facial hair and hair on the top of your head work on different feedback loops to define when to grow and for how long. This is why DHT sensitivity can drastically affect the top of your head in a bad way, but can also increase the amount of facial hair you have. When shaving your Adam's apple, "Hi, I'm Adam, by the way. In order to not cut yourself, swallow and hold to make it flatter. Your man tip is to swallow. Got it. Enjoy Reddit gold. I cut that mother ducker all the time. Holy shit. Do you have any idea how much this is going to change my shaving routine? My Adam's apple is the only part one usually would cut a tiny bit. Never had I thought about swallowing before trying to shave it. I don't know who told you this or where you learned it from, but thank you for passing the info along. Or just slightly pull the skin to one side then the other to save yourself from choking with a sharp implement near your jugular. Either or. Give a firm handshake when you meet someone. Look people in the eye. Smile. First impressions are everything. And don't ride in anything with a Caperson 38 engine. They fall right out of the sky. And after a while, you can work on points for style. Like the club tire and the firm handshake, a certain look in the eye and an easy smile. Compliment a woman on her shoes. It does wonders. Got it. Compliment shoes, not boobies. This. Compliment anything you know a woman puts effort into. It shows you've noticed and appreciate it. Whether they did it for themselves or an interest, they can still take that compliment to the bank. Compliments work well in everyday social interaction, but I've also found that if you're out at the bars downtown, a legitimate compliment goes a long way to pique their interest in you. Part of it is because girls get hit on with some shitty line, or a guy buys her a drink expecting he's owed something. A compliment in passing is a good way to show you've noticed the effort, but keep walking with your friends to another part of the bar. Just do it. This is a good non-threatening way to see if she's interested. It only takes seconds for someone to determine visually if they're interested. If you catch her looking more than a few times when she's with her friends, it's probably safe to say you can approach and talk a little. She's watching you interact, what you've ordered, how you dress, your status with the group, status of the group, if you're laughing, and the off chance you might be gay. It's not a bad thing. It creates a dip in expectations if she's attracted to you, so when you do go to talk to her and her friends, always include the friends. Don't be a horn dog ass clown and you show interest in women. The compliment from earlier with compounded interest in her friends bring those expectations and her interest in you way higher than if you were to approach as a douche bro. I don't know why I turned this into an advice rant. Edit 1. Punctuation and grammar. A steak needs to rest after it comes off the heat for a few minutes before you cut into it for maximum flavor. You can use a rubber band to pull out a stripped screw by placing it in between the screw and your screwdriver slash drill. Don't be ashamed or embarrassed to ask questions when you don't know something. More often than not, the other person will be willing to show you. I'll have to try that stripped screw thing sometime. Currently, I use one of those stripped screw extraction kits I got at Home Depot. Basically, you use one bit that drills a cone in the screw head. Then you flip the bit over, and it's got grabby bits that dig into the side of the cone you just drilled, and out comes the screw. Awesome for stripped track screws. Bullshit on the stripped screws. Tried it a couple of times, and it didn't work. I found the best way to remove a stripped screw is to get a sturdy screwdriver, place it in the screw, then take a hammer and give it a whack or two, then try and remove it. Yeah, gotta wash your butthole. Edit, and don't be afraid to dig in a little. You have an inner and an outer sphincter, and there is usually a bit of shit residue left between the two, which with a bit of sweating will work its way out. If ya must, wash your winky. The majority of the time, a woman doesn't want you to solve her problems when venting to you. Rather, she just wants you to listen to said problems slash issues. I read a book written about a bunch of polls taken by women. The whole thing really helped me understand the differences in how men slash women think. Edit, for those curious, here's the book I'm talking about. It is written by Jeff and Shaunti Feldman. Shaunti wrote a book called For Women Only, and it was based of polls from men talking about how they think. Shaunti's book was so popular, Jeff decided to make one for women. And at only 200 pages and $10 for each, it's a real easy read. I hate reading, and I read both of them. Cannot restate this enough. Married for 16 years. The best advice is just to shut the duck up, pour her a glass of wine, and listen. You have been visited by the seal pupper. This pupper will bring you luck for 24 hours, but only if you comment you're so cute, seal pupper. Thanks for watching. Do not forget to subscribe for more daily videos.